is going to fill a large part of your life. And the only true way to be truly satisfied is to believe what you do is great work. And the only way to do great work is to do what you love. If you haven't found it yet, keep looking. Don't settle. As for all matters of your heart, you will know when you will find it. Now, can anyone tell me who said this famous line?
Henry Ford. Steve Jobs.
Yep. It was quoted by Steve Jobs in his famous Sanford Stadium speech. If you extract the meaning, it simply says, follow your passion. What is passion? Passion is all about enjoying the moment. It's about waking up, feeling excited to be alive, and feeling grateful to be doing what you do. You jump out of bed humming and getting ready to tackle the day. You are living life through your heart. Till now, you have learned what Steve Jobs said. Now, let me tell you what Steve Jobs didn't say in his speech. Steve Jobs never mentioned he was not passionate about technology. Instead, he was passionate about calligraphy, Western history, and dance. Had he taken up his passion, probably would have ended somewhere completely different. It was by accident he bumped into one technology wizard, Stephen Gary, both of whom then decided to work together, and thus, the rest is history. Today, keeping this speech in mind, I aim to free you from the simplistic catchphrases like, follow your passion, do what you love, the type of catchphrases that have spawned the career confusion that afflicts so many of us today. Instead, I will try to provide you with a realistic path towards a meaningful and engaging working life. Carl Newport, in his book So Good They Can't Ignore You, mentions the story of a young man named Thomas. He was a banker by profession, but his mind kept wandering and he was not happy with his profession. He quit and went on to find his true calling. He went to become a Buddhist monk. Years later, he was not satisfied there as well. He returned to banking again, but this time it was different for him. He was freed from the escapist thought of some fantasy job waiting for him. Instead, he was trying to focus on the task he was given and accomplish that well. He was freed from the constant draining comparison between his current work and some dream job waiting to be explored. He realized occupational happiness, having a perfect job, is not occupational happiness. Follow your passion advice, its main problem is it pre-assumes we all have a pre-existing passion. Most of us, probably me, I don't know what my passion is. People often mistake their hobbies with their passions. In 2002, a research team administered a questionnaire among 539 Canadian university students. They had only two questions in the questionnaire. Does this student have passion? And if yes, what are they? 84% of the students said they have passion. Great, right? But the problem is, the top five identified passion were dance, swimming, reading, skiing, and playing ice hockey. In fact, only 4% or less than 4% had any relation of their passion relating to work or education. 96% had their passion identified relating to sports and arts. In his book, Carl Newport also mentions there are two different types of people who thinks differently about their jobs. The first one is the craftsman mindset, which focuses on what you can offer to them. The second is the passion mindset, which focuses on what the world can offer. The craftsman mindset asks you to leave behind the self-centered concerns about whether your job is just right and instead focus on the job in hand and get so better they can't ignore it. Malcolm Gladwell, in his book Outliners, mentions the 10,000 hour rule. The idea is to gain excellence at solving a complex situation which surfaces in your business again and again, you require a certain degree of expertise. In fact, researchers have now settled for what they believe is the minimum critical level of experience, 10,000 hours. Now, it's not that you will gain expertise even after 10,000 hours. You have to utilize those 10,000 hours as well. Don't follow your passion. Don't follow your true calling. Instead, try to build, master rare and valuable skills. And once you have the career capital that these skills generate, invest it wisely to gain control over what you do and how you do it. Remember, working right trumps finding the right.